My name is Christine Marquette, and I'm a registered and licensed dietitian with the Austin Regional Clinic, and I'm going to talk to you about potassium. Potassium is one of the required minerals in our body. It acts as a cation in the body. It's often referred to as one of the electrolytes. Electrolytes also include sodium, calcium, magnesium, and chloride. The way potassium works in the body is it interacts with the other electrolytes to maintain fluid balance and to maintain acid base balance, as well as to make sure that waste products are regulated effectively. Most potassium is actually found in the muscle tissue, so often a measurement of potassium is used to determine a person's muscle mass. If they have a low potassium level in their muscle tissue, that indicates that they have some type of muscle wasting condition, some type of protein wasting condition. Potassium that's found in the fluids also is an indicator of kidney function and, again, your acid-base balance. So if somebody has very low potassium levels, they may have had an excessive amount of vomiting or diarrhea, or they have experienced some other form of fluid loss. Say, for example, they were in a very bad accident and had a lot of blood loss, or a very bad trauma such as a burn that their body flooded that particular area or that particular wound with a lot of blood. So that's another type of reason that could cause a low level of potassium. Potassium generally also is recognized for its role in muscle and heart regulation. A lot of times if people are deficient in potassium, they'll experience cramping and they will experience problems with their heart if they also have low or extremely high levels of potassium, irregular heartbeat, or they could even experience cardiac arrest. So potassium is a very important mineral. It has a lot of functions in the body, and it's important that it is kept at normal levels.